heavy equipment refers to heavy-duty vehicles, specially designed for executing construction tasks, most frequently ones involving earthwork operations. They are also known as heavy machines, heavy trucks, construction equipment, engineering equipment, heavy vehicles, or heavy hydraulics. They usually comprise five equipment systems: implement, traction, structure, powertrain, control and information. Heavy equipment functions through the mechanical advantage of a simple machine. The ratio between input force applied and force exerted is multiplied. Some equipment uses hydraulic drives as a primary source of motion. History. JCB-3CX backhoe loader, a wheeled bulldozer in an open-pit coal mine, a portable engine, a precursor to modern engineering vehicles, an early gasoline-powered tractor. The use of heavy equipment has a long history. The ancient Roman engineer Vitruvius gave descriptions of heavy equipment and cranes in ancient Rome. In his treatise De Architectura, the pile driver was invented around 1500. The first tunneling shield was patented by Isambard Kingdom Brunel in 1818. From horses, through steam, to diesel until the 19th century and into the early 20th century, heavy machines were drawn under human or animal power. The design of a core tractor evolved around the new steam power source into a new machine core traction engine that can be configured as the steam tractor and the steam roller. During the 20th century, internal combustion engines became the major power source of heavy equipment. Kerosene, ethanol and engines were used, but today diesel engines are dominant. Mechanical transmission was in many cases replaced by hydraulic machinery. The early 20th century also saw new electric-powered machines such as the forklift. Caterpillar Inc. is a present-day brand from these days, starting out as the Holt Manufacturing Company. The first mass-produced heavy machine was the Fordson tractor in 1917. The first commercial continuous track vehicle was the Lombard steam log hauler from 1901. Tracks became extensively used for tanks during World War I, and after the war they became commonplace for civilian machinery such as the bulldozer, the largest engineering vehicles, and the largest mobile land machines altogether, a bucket wheel excavators built from the 1920s. Until almost the 20th century, one simple tool constituted the primary earth-moving machine. The hand shovel moved with animal and human-powered sleds, barges, and wagons. This tool was the principal method by which material was either sidecast or elevated to load a conveyance, usually a wheelbarrow, or a cart or wagon drawn by a draft animal. In antiquity, an equivalent of the hand shovel or hoe and head basket, and masses of men, were used to move earth to build civil works. Builders have long used the inclined plane, levers, and pulleys to place solid building materials. But these labor-saving devices did not lend themselves to earth-moving, which required digging, raising, moving, and placing loose materials. The two elements required for mechanized earth-moving, then as now, were an independent power source and off-road mobility, neither of which could be provided by the technology of that time. Container cranes were used from the 1950s and onwards, and made containerization possible. Nowadays, such is the importance of this machinery. Some transport companies have developed specific equipment to transport heavy construction equipment to and from sites. Types. These subdivisions, in this order, are the standard heavy equipment categorization. Some contractors place numbers on the side of their equipment corresponding to the category, grader, O2, followed by a sequential number that usually corresponds to the number it was purchased. For example, 02112 is a 112th grader a company has purchased since their founding. This allows for easy recognition of the equipment type and the relevant age. Track type: agricultural tractors, air track, bulldozer, snowcat, track skidder. Track type: tractors, tractor, military engineering vehicles, Grader, grader. Skid steer loader. Excavator, compact excavator. Dragline excavator. Dredging excavator. Excavator. Slurry wall excavator. Front shovel. Reclaimer. Steam shovel. Suction excavator. Trencher. Yarder. Backhoe, backhoe loader, backhoe, timber feller buncher, harvester, skidder, track harvester, wheel forwarder, wheel skidder, pipe layer, scraper, Fresno scraper, scraper, wheel tractor scraper, mining construction and mining tractor, construction and mining trucks, articulated, articulated hauler, articulated truck, water wagon, compactor wheeldozers, soil compactors, soil stabilizer, loader, loader, skip loader, wheel loader, track loader, track loader, material handler, aerial work platform, lift table, boom truck, cherry picker, crane, forklift, knuckle boom loader and knuckle boom loader, reach stacker, telescopic handlers, paving asphalt paver, asphalt plant, cold planer, concrete batch plant, cure rig, paver, pneumatic tire compactor, roller, slip form paver, vibratory compactor, compactor, stomper, concrete drop hammer, underground road header, tunnel boring machine, underground mining equipment, hydromatic tool, ballast tamper, attachments, drilling machine, pile driver, rotary tiller, venturi mixer, highway dump truck, highway 10-yard rear dump, highway bottom dump pup, triple, highway end dump and side dump, highway transfer, transfer train, highway transit mixer, lowboy, street sweeper. Images: the Caterpillar D10N bulldozer evolved from track-type tractors and is characterized by a steel blade attached to the front that is used to push other equipment and construction materials, such as earth. Normally the bucket is pulled toward the excavator to excavate material. The uncommon thumb attachment on this Caterpillar enables grabbing objects, for example, during demolition. The wheel trencher, Marais SMC200R, iron bar reinforced foundation piles are driven with a drilling machine, concrete pump, mixer truck, and a specialized auger that allows pumping concrete through its axis while withdrawn. Wheel loader, grader, landfill compactor, a wheeled front loader tractor equipped with a large bucket elevated by hydraulic rams. Reconditioned Caterpillar 825G soil compactor, folded conveyor on a tract grinder, military engineering vehicles. The militarized Caterpillar D9 armored bulldozer allows for earth-moving projects in a combat environment. In the picture, IDF Caterpillar D9R, the militarized Hutter-Stalowa-Wola backhoe loader in Poland, which is subsidiary of Lugong China, military scraper, pipe stacks, armored engineering vehicle of the German army, implements and hydromechanical work tools, auger, backhoe, bale spear, broom, bulldozer blade, clamshell bucket, cold plane, demolition shears, equipment bucket, excavator bucket, forks, disambiguation needed, grapple, hydraulic hammer, hoe ram, hydraulics, hydraulic tilting bucket, landscape tiller, material handling arm, mechanical pulverizer, crusher, multiprocessor, pavement removal bucket, pile driver, power takeoff, quick coupler, rake, ripper, rotating grab, sheep's foot compactor, skeleton bucket, snowblower, stump grinder, stump shear, thumb, tilt rotator, trencher, vibratory plate compactor, wheel saw, traction, off-the-road tires and tracks. Heavy equipment requires specialized tires for various construction applications, while many types of equipment have continuous tracks applicable to more severe service requirements. Tires are used where a greater speed or mobility is required. An understanding of what equipment will be used for during the life of the tires is required for proper selection. Tire selection can have a significant impact on production and unit cost. There are three types of off-the-road tires: transport for earth-moving machines, work for slow-moving earth-moving machines, and load and carry for transporting as well as digging. Off-highway tires have six categories of service: C compactor, E earth mover, G grader, L loader, LS log skidder, and ML mining and logging. Within these service categories are various tread types designed for use on hard-packed surface, soft surface, and rock. Tires are a large expense on any construction project. Careful consideration should be given to prevent excessive wear or damage. Structure. This system connects components, transmits loads, provides attachment points for implements, and allows the machine to travel over uneven ground. The machine's frame, articulation, and steering for wheeled equipment are the major parts of this system. Powertrain. Internal combustion engine. Transmission. Steering. Brakes. Control and information. The control and information systems. These systems enable the operator to direct and control all the other systems and provide information to guide operations or to monitor the performance and health of the equipment. Heavy equipment operator. A heavy equipment operator drives and operates heavy equipment used in engineering and construction projects. Typically, only skilled workers may operate heavy equipment, and there is specialized training for learning to use heavy equipment. Much publication about heavy equipment operators focuses on improving safety for such workers. The field of occupational medicine researches and makes recommendations about safety for these and other workers in safety-sensitive positions. Equipment cost. Due to the small profit margins on construction projects, it is important to maintain accurate records concerning equipment utilization, repairs, and maintenance. The two main categories of equipment costs are ownership cost and operating cost. Ownership cost to classify as an ownership cost, an expense must have been incurred regardless of if the equipment is used or not. These costs are as follows. Purchase expense. Salvage value. Tax savings from depreciation. Major repairs and overhauls. Property taxes. Insurance. Storage. Depreciation can be calculated several ways. The simplest is the straight line method. The annual depreciation is constant, reducing the equipment value annually. The following are simple equations paraphrased from the Purifoy and Schneider text. Operating cost. For an expense to be classified as an operating cost, it must be incurred through use of the equipment. These costs are as follows. The biggest distinction from a cost standpoint is if a repair is classified as a major repair or a minor repair. A major repair can change the depreciable equipment value due to an extension in service life, while a minor repair is normal maintenance. How a firm chooses to cost major and minor repairs vary from firm to firm depending on the costing strategies being used. Some firms will charge only major repairs to the equipment while minor repairs are costed to a project. Many firms keep their costing structure closely guarded as it can impact the bidding strategies of their competition. In a company with multiple semi-independent divisions, the equipment department often wants to classify all repairs as minor and charge the work to a job, therefore improving their profit from the equipment models. Die-cast metal promotional scale models of heavy equipment are often produced for each vehicle to give to prospective customers. These are typically in 150 scale. The popular manufacturers of these models are Conrad and NZG in Germany, even for US vehicles. Notable manufacturers. The largest manufacturers based on 2011 revenue data as published by KHL Group. Caterpillar Inc., Komatsu, Volvo Construction Equipment, Hitachi Hitachi, Limited, Liebherr Group, SANY Group Company Limited, Zoomlion, Terex, Doosan Infracore, including Solar Brand, Deere & Company, XCMG. Other manufacturers include Atlas Copco, Bharat Earth Movers Limited, Bobcat Company, Case, Chelyabinsk Tractor Plant, CNH Global, Demag, Doosan Group, Fiat Alice, Hyundai Heavy Industries, Ingersoll Rand, JCB, Kubota, Kobelco, Lugong, Madel, Marais, Navistar International Corporation, NCK, New Holland, Track Marshall, Orenstein and Koppel GmbH, Packard, Poklane, Rototilt, Shantui, Saint Kinetics, Takuch Manufacturing, Wacker Neuson.